were great, but are you okay?
I'm hanging in there, literally, hanging.
Did something happen to you, or you...
I was playing basketball, and I tore my Achilles.
Right before coming to AGT.
Yeah, I had to. I didn't want to miss this opportunity to perform for you guys, so...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What is your name?
My name is Barry Brewer.
Barry, where are you from?
I'm from the south side of Chicago.
Yeah!
Hey!
Well, the good thing is that you, whatever you're gonna do, looks like you're gonna do it sitting down, no?
Yes, I was gonna do stand-up comedy, but I'm gonna do sit-down today, so.
Oh. How did you realize that you had that gift?
I'm a musician, and I grew up playing in church on the weekends, and this guy said, man, you're funny. I was playing the drums for this community choir. He said, you should do some jokes for the concert. And I said, for real? And I did a church performance, and I got a standing ovation my first time, and I've been chasing that dream ever since.
Oh, wow. Okay, Barry, good luck tonight.
Thank you so much.
Break a leg.
Thank you, Hal. I appreciate it.
I got
thank you,
you
so much.
I got you. There we go. All right.
Woo, thank you so much. Yeah, I did travel here from Chicago.
Oh my gosh, wow.
And when I traveled, I thought that, you know, I would get a little empathy because I was on crutches because I like to go on vacation and forget I'm black sometimes. Some people don't understand, it's a little stressful. When I got on the plane, this young lady clenched onto her purse. You know how you have to stand in first class and wait to get to coach. And she clenched onto her purse like I was gonna take it, and I was offended for two reasons. First reason is I can still take it. You're not that strong. You know what I mean? Like, you ain't been in the gym like that. Your little strength ain't gonna stop my yank if I was a thief. And then second reason, where I'm gonna go? I have crutches. You think I'm gonna steal your purse and go sit in 32C? I just think everybody should love everybody, right? Like, I just really believe in that. And being a musician, man, I got to play for different churches. I grew up and I learned how to play in church, so I got to play for black church and white church. White church is a little more simple. Their Jesus is simple. The chords are simple. The pastor, he gets up, he does his message. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Thank you, God, that whosoever believeth in him, you just have to believe, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And church is over. That is church in white church. It's real simple to the point. Black church, I grew up, is different. You go to church on Sunday, and then when they preach, it's like serious, like, put your hands together for Jesus. He's been too good. Hey, yeah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hey! I know white people be like, their Jesus is angry. Jesus is very angry. Their Jesus has been through a lot. Thank you so much. I'm very good. God bless.
So what is your talent? What will you be doing for us today?
I am a stand-up comedian.
What got you into comedy?
Well, I say a gift from God, but really, it's you grew up in a big Irish Catholic family with five siblings. You're always taking the crap out of each other, and it's just part of a natural wit, I think. You'll see.
Okay, the stage is yours. Have fun.
Thank you.
And hopefully we have some fun with you.
I don't want to hate people, they make me hate them. I'm all about love, you feel that immediately with me. But I was on the airplane coming here, a woman in the seat behind me, she gets up and she starts spritzing cinnamon. I go, lady, what are you doing? She goes, well, it's natural. I go, so's my butt, but I'm not putting it in your face. I didn't want to hate her. She made me hate her. Do you see what's happening there?
Yes.
I'm a victim. I had a car accident recently. I'm all right, don't worry. Young guy, stoned out of his mind, on his cell phone, music blaring, looked a lot like you. Gets out of his car, you know, with the man bun. Dude, I don't know what happened, dude. I'm like, oh, what happened is in 1999, your mother forgot her birth control. That's what happened, dude. Say that, he made me say it. I was a victim. I was victimized. Okay, so but truth be told, I am at that age post-period, pre-death. That's my age range. Here it is. I don't want to be a cougar. Absolutely not. I don't need some young hot guy named Chad touching my belly fat going, ooh, what's this? What's this? This is rage. Rage, covered by affordable treats and wine from Trader Joe's. That's what this is. We got going here, baby. Yeah. Yes. Yes. You know what I want? This is what I want. I want a guy around 86 years old, where I am the hottest thing between him and death. He can't believe he got me, because he knows he'll never get anyone better to the day he dies. And he's not looking over his shoulder for somebody younger and hotter. You know why? He has arthritis in his neck. He can't move his neck. And he sees none of my flaws. He sees no cellulite, belly fat, varicose veins. Why? Cataracts. Cataracts. And you know what? Let me tell you something. I love him. And I look into his milky white eyes. And I say, I love you! Because he's hard of hearing and I want him to know. Because I'm all about love. Thanks, you guys. I'm Maureen Langan. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Jersey, 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 Jersey.
Thank you. That means a lot, you guys. Thank you so much.
You're funny, Maureen. It's the timing. You just have this really good timing
and
your voice and how you just like bam, 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 bam. You just have the next one coming and the next one coming. I mean, I was laughing a lot. So were you. So were you.
Yeah, well, everybody was.
Were you laughing, Simon?
So funny, so fearless. That's what Simon says.
Thank you.
What about you, Sophia?
It was fascinating. Your energy, the way that you control the stage, you didn't miss one beat. You know your material.
She had like the body
movement. She was so tough.
Yeah.
You feel like you need to be like on a TV show, actually.
Thank you.
Yes.
You know, you have a voice where we can hear you and we can hear your rhythm and we can hear your attitude and we love it and we connect with it. I think people not only are gonna love you, they will imitate you, they'll want to see you, you have catchphrases,
yes.
You have everything in that arsenal that a great comedian needs. You are ready to explode.
Thank you.
I wanted to love you, and I did love you.
More women in comedy!
Let's vote. I'm going to give you a first yes. You were fantastic.
Second yes.
Sophia!
I think people are going to love you.
Hello.
What's your name and your age?
My name is Aaron Belial, and I'm 28 years old.
Okay. And what is your talent?
Well, I can't dance. So I'm gonna do stand-up comedy.
Oh, wonderful. How long have you been doing this?
I did my first open mic about a year ago.
What got you into comedy?
Last winter, I ended up in Portugal. I ended up going to a comedy show there and making all the comics laugh, and they convinced me to try it.
Wow. So comedy generally is about timing. What is your process?
Please hold while the operator types his response. To do my comedy, I use a text-to-speech app, Interestingly enough, the silence while I type just builds tension during a set, and I think people enjoy watching me laugh at my own joke that I'm writing. You should also know that if you heckle me, my service dog is trained to go for the vocal cords.
Can I ask, do you have a day job?
I'm an engineer.
So, young man, the stage is yours. Best of luck.
Most of you look super confused right now, so let's talk about the elephant in the room. I know what you're all thinking. Who ordered Stephen Hawking off of Wish.com? He might be smarter than me, but I would beat him in a race. Unless the race is downhill, then I'm screwed. We also have different conditions. He had amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, and I am Canadian. Specifically, I'm half French, on my left side. I also have a brain muscle disability called cerebral palsy, but being French is way worse than a brain disability. I used to have the word handicapped in my social media bio, and then some random white lady messaged me telling me I need to change it to disabled.
Oh!
You can't say that word anymore. It is offensive to disabled people.
I don't think it's offensive. Last time I checked, I was pretty disabled.
Well, you don't get to decide what is offensive or not to disabled people.
Who the hell does then? Some two-legged, white woman on Facebook, who is probably commenting on her phone from a handicapped bathroom stall. Thank you for listening.
I cannot believe you've only been doing this for 1 year, because you seem to have a grasp of timing and humor. You open up the conversation and normalize humanity and originality, and you're funny. I think, sir, you're not going to be doing engineering much longer. I think you're going to be full-time performing. That's my prediction. So I'm going to start off the voting with a yes.
That makes it 4 yeses. The story of my life.
People often think my disability defines my existence. They say something like, oh, you have cerebral palsy. I know another guy with cerebral palsy. You should be best friends. But they don't like it when I go up and say, oh, you're an idiot. Know someone else who's an idiot. You should be best friends. And you don't get that with any other medical conditions either. I've never heard someone say, oh, you have herpes. My brother has herpes. You should be best friends. I have cerebral palsy. CP does not affect intelligence or hearing. In fact, the most interesting symptom of cerebral palsy is how it makes other people freaking stupid. For example, people come up to me and start gesturing at me, yelling real slow like, hello, can I pet your doggie? And I'm like, oh my, are you okay? Are you having a stroke? Do you need me to call 911? Oh, you're just an idiot. I guess we don't need an ambulance for that. People always ask why I need a service dog. I don't. You got me, I'm faking it. He has two primary services. First, he gets my beer for me. Good boy. Now number two, fetch me a girlfriend. You're ruining my set, you jerk. Go fetch Sophia Viagra. Oh no. Damn autocorrect. I meant Sophia Vergara. We're almost done. But remember, if you don't vote for me, he won't eat tonight. I'm just kidding. Of course he'll eat tonight. He's the one that makes us dinner. Okay, make funny jokes, check. Hit on Sophia, check. Brought dog out for bonus votes, check. Perfect. That's my time. Love you all.
Sophia!
Well, I think this... I love the way you look at life. I love that that's what makes you so funny, that you make fun of yourself, that you're, like, so, like, happy with yourself. And,
Has anyone ever called you Sophia?
No, they have called me like that before,
Viagra?
But... I'm single.
Simon! No.
You are naturally funny. I mean, just that. I mean, if you're a comedian, that's what it's all about. And interestingly, unlike other acts tonight, I actually wanted it to go on longer. And you know, one of my favorite bits was when the dog, even the dog's face when he was looking at you, even the dog's funny. He was just giving you this look like, yeah, yeah, yeah. But that was good.
Bravo!
Howie, you are on your feet.
Yeah, man. I'm on my feet because I love this guy. I agree with Sophia. If anybody deserves to go on and voted for one of the two, it is you. Your timing is great. Your personality is great. And I've been a fan of yours since you were first here. I love when you work dirty. We can't see it here, but you're brilliant.
Sophia, after Aaron flirted with you on the show last night, we got a lot of questions asking what you're looking for in a partner.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh.
Well, I think what every girl wants, someone...
I am taken.
Someone healthy, yeah. Someone handsome, someone that has a great sense of humor.
I'm married!
Someone that is happy with himself, that's it.
Okay, okay.
I'm married!
Oh, he's married, oh, he's married, all right. From AGT Socials, Liz from Ohio said, tell Heidi to get a pair of glasses so she doesn't have to cup her hands around her eyes to see. Heidi, do those hand binoculars actually work?
Well, my hand binoculars, they're just to cut out the light. So sometimes if they're up in the air and I can't see them well, I cut the light like this. I do have glasses, but I'm too vain to wear them. I have glasses.
Yeah. Can you see now?
It's all good. It's all nice and fuzzy. No, this
is
definitely...
You might want to wear them when you're judging. That's for real.
See, I
don't know if I look so good in glasses. Anyway.
No.
It's not working.
I'm sure you can hear the excitement in my voice.
It's not working.
Sorry, I got a text and my phone died. Please hold. Hi, I'm so happy to be back for the finals. I'm sure you can hear the excitement in my voice. I have to compete against an army of French hand dancers. But as you may know, I am half French myself. So Levé decided to do my own little ditty with my French hand. Come on, Howie, do it with me. Oh my God, that's so offensive. I'm trying to get a green card to live the American dream. I've tried everything. At this point, LM questioning if Howie is even here legally. I seriously don't understand why it's so hard. I mean, they let Simon in and he's, well, Simon. One downside of my disability is I can only ever break up with women over text. What kind of jerk does that? I'm just a regular guy, but people don't understand that. Recently, someone said you should date someone like you, and I say, you mean a smart, funny, and compassionate person? The strong and silent type? And then they turn into a malfunctioning robot.
No, you know what I mean. You know.
What do you want me to do? Wear a sign saying, you must be, this, disabled to ride? I recently went to a theme park, and I asked for a disability pass. The guy says, your disability does not qualify. Okay, can you tell me where I have to go to upgrade my disability? How much to upgrade to platinum cripple? I didn't get a pass, but I went to the fast lane anyway, and they took one look at me, and they're like, yeah, he's tall enough. Another thing, people talk to my friends expecting them to answer for me, like asking them what I want to order at a restaurant. And I'm like, you know he's deaf, right? And even worse, he's a vegan. Servers always push the bill towards my able-bodied friends, not realizing that their disability is being cheap wankers. One waitress started cutting my steak for me even though I asked her not to. I'm like, don't you try and feed me. And she's like, chugga chugga choo chiawoo. So for fun, I told her I'm like a baby bird, and she needs to chew it and regurgitate it into my mouth. Having a service dog is hard too. Like Ubers say no pets and drive away. Sir, he's not a pet. He's a medical device like a wheelchair. And because you're a jerk, now I need to ride him home. I told Al that he could tell one joke this time. People are gonna be like, he's using his dog for votes. Damn right. I would bring my grandmother out here on a leash if it would help. Remember to vote for me, the best dog dance ventriloquist comedian singing act on season 18.
La 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 la.
Maybe if I win, Simon will adopt me and make my American dream come true. Thank you, AGT. This whole experience has left me speechless.
Aaron Bilal! Howie!
Well done. I love when you get edgy. I love when you... And somebody texted you? Who knows your number that was calling in the middle that doesn't know you're doing this? I would hate them right now. I hate them right now, but it was funny. You're funny. You deserve to be here.
Simon!
So that really was not part of the act?
No.
Oh, I mean, unbelievable. No. Then you're even better than I thought. I mean, look, what I love about you, Aaron, is there are times where we're looking at each other going, did he just say that? You're so edgy and so funny, and that's why you're here. Brilliant.
It was real.
Heidi!
It's been an absolute privilege to watch you on your journey. You know, you've been fantastic. You've made us laugh. You inspired us. And I also want to wish you good luck for tonight.
Sophia!
We've been so lucky to have you here as, you know, part of this season because you've been fun. You've been, you know, a delight. You feel so confident. I mean, you can teach us a lot of things. Good luck tonight.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Georgie. Georgie Carroll.
Where are you from, Georgie?
I'm Australian now, but initially Rochdale, hence the move.
I like Rochdale.
Have you been?
So you live in Australia now?
Yeah.
Okay, and then now you come back here to do Britain's Got Talent?
Yeah.
It's a long trip.
Yeah.
What's your day job?
So I'm a nurse. I've been a registered nurse since 2000.
Well, I love to make people laugh.
I've got it. Okay, 3 minutes, yours, Georgie. Good luck.
So I've got teenage boys. They do swear a lot. They are prone to kicking off. A bit like having Gordon Ramsay trapped in a child's body. But it's my favourite category of human. What I like about them is the way that their self-esteem far outweighs their skill set. My boys heckle Sir David Attenborough when they're watching Blue Planet. You can't do that. Sir David invented animals. I wish I believed in myself that much. I really do. I've worked out a foolproof way of lecturing a teenager. You've got to trap it somewhere where it can't escape, but it feels safe. The car wash. It's perfect. Took mine through the car wash for a bit of counselling. Just something about hygiene. He goes, oh, let me get through puberty, will you? I said, what do you think comes after puberty? And he says, adultery. I said, you know, statistically, you're correct there. He wasn't listening anyway. We had 3 minutes left on the car wash, so I just put the window down. He got a wash. Thank you so much. Oh, thanks.
Very good. That's the thing about a comedian. You can't fake it. If you're funny, people laugh. If you're not, nothing happens. Yep. Simple as that.
Thank you. Rock on.
I absolutely loved it, and I will never go on a car wash again.
Georgie, I was roaring.
When it ended, Alicia and I were like, oh, my God, no, we want more now.
I really, really loved it. I'm saying yes.
Of course it's a yes.
Thank you.
It's a yes from me.
That means you got 4 yeses, Georgie.
Thank you.
Isn't it fun out here?
It's fun, man.
How is it when you're like in the wing, about to come out? Are you nervous then, or?
But Terry's back there.
What is he doing over there?
No, just, you know, giving motivational talks and everything. I think he has a TED Talk coming up or something. I don't know.
Okay, so tell us, who are you, how old are you, and where are you from, please?
My name is Orlando Leyva. I am 45 from Miami, Florida. And I'm a stand-up comic.
How did you get into that?
It's my wife. It was my birthday, and she gave me a gift to the school that teaches you improv acting. Mm-hmm. And then the improv teacher says, you're not good at improv. You should try stand-up.
And now you're here on the biggest stage in the world.
What a journey, man.
Take it away.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
I like this vibe.
Thank you, thank you. I'm happy to be here. My name is Orlando. I'm married, 15 years. You could hear it in my voice. There's a little essence of defeat every time I open my mouth. You hear it, like every good husband. Listen, woman, you wanna get gelato after this? Is that possible? She's a good woman. She got me into that show, Yellowstone. I love that show. Yeah, it's a great show, but I feel like less of a man every time that I watch. Should I buy a truck? I feel like I should buy a truck. For those that don't know, Yellowstone is a TV show about a cattle ranch ran by the bodyguard himself, Kevin Costner. Yeah, a man, right? The writing is great, the acting is excellent, but the visuals of Yellowstone are amazing. Yellowstone, the park looks amazing. So imagine my excitement when my buddy Eric invited me to his wedding. Where? In Yellowstone. Are you coming? Oh, I'm there. I've been watching the show. The second I landed, guys, I got it. This place was so beautiful, so majestic. I understood Kevin Costner. Shoot, I became Kevin Costner. By the third day, I was telling people to get off my land. Get off my land! Sure, it was in the hotel courtyard, but that's the way that I felt. I couldn't stop saying, go on, get. You go on, get. You go on, get from that cucumber water, sir. You've had enough of our minerals. Thank you. I drove out into the park. I'm a city guy, man, and I was out there in nature, unsupervised. I saw elks, the real ones with the coat racks. I saw elks. I saw bears doing bear stuff. They waved at me. One got a little bit too close. I said, you go on get, Yogi. I told him. Here's a big one. I saw bisons. Those are real. I thought bisons were made up like unicorns, but there he was, a bison in the middle of the road looking like a bougie cow, moo. I see you, bougie cow. I see you. I kept driving because they told me to go see Old Faithful. Old Faithful, for those that don't know, is a thermal geyser that shoots water and steam out into the sky from the middle of the earth. Allegedly, I hadn't seen it yet. When I got there, they call it Old Faithful because Old Faithful always goes off right on time, plus or minus 10 minutes. I read the sign. And Old Faithful did not let us down. It went off right on time, plus 10 minutes. It reminded me of me in my 20s. I was like, I remember when I could do that. Yeah, I can't do that anymore. I can't. I'm more like old dependable. Or old maybe later, plus or minus 10 days. It all depends how my tummy feels. My name's Orlando Leyva. Thank you so much, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you, beautiful girl?
I'm Mandy Muden. I'm from London in the United Kingdom.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
Oh.
It's been a rough couple of years, you know what I mean?
And what do you do, Mandy?
I do magic.
Why AGT? Now?
Well, being British, as Simon will back me up to say, I love America. Also, I owe money and had to get out of the UK.
What are you going to do with $1 million if you win?
Well, I'd probably spend it on men.
On men? Okay, we're ready for you. We want to see your magic.
Okay, fantastic. Right, everybody, are you ready to get into a magic mood? Okay, America's Got Talent. Look at this. Four strangers ready to judge me. It's like one of those parties where you throw the car keys into the fishbowl. Heidi,
yes?
Would you just... I've got a bag here full of letters. Could you just reach in and get a few out just to make sure that they're all different? It's very difficult with the gloves on, isn't it? If you just committed a crime and hoping to get away with it.
They all look different.
Lovely. Shove that back. I'll give the bag a bit of a shake. Hi, Howie.
Hi.
I want you just to take a letter.
One?
Don't look at it.
Okay.
Okay, fantastic. Could you take one as well?
Take it out?
Yes, please. And don't look at it. We'll come back to that later. Okay, Sophia, could you do the same? Okay, fantastic. Now, Simon, I'm going to riffle through my book. Could you just stick anything in you like?
Finger?
Yes, a finger would be lovely, okay. Simon. Okay, brilliant. Now, Simon, could you look at the page number?
Yes.
And the first word on the page, Simon.
Got it.
Okay, and could you write them down and remember them?
Yes, I can.
Okay, fantastic. I'm just going to pop back up to the stage. Feel free to check me out, Simon. Okay. Right, here we go. Now, Howie, I want you to think of any word at all in the English language.
Okay.
Now, would you be impressed if the word you were thinking of was written on a piece of paper in the bag in front of you?
Yes, more than impressed.
Please open the bag.
It's a dictionary.
Unbelievable. Heidi and Sophia, open your packages. Okay, Heidi, what lovely love story do you have, Heidi?
Mine says 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, now Simon, what page were you on?
70.
Okay, Heidi, could you turn to page 70? I'm just going to go into a trance and read your mind. Here we go. Page 70. Does your word begin with an F?
Yes.
Right, lovely. Now, are you familiar with this word?
Yes, I'm familiar with the word.
Okay. Oh my God. Now, the spirits are telling me that this word ends in I-N-G, okay? Have you done this word today?
Yes.
That's my girl, fantastic. Is your word by any chance, is it fantasizing?
Yes, it is.
Okay, now, Sophia, could you go to 17? Could you look at the last word on page 70, Sophia?
I don't have my glasses. 70.
Okay, Howie, you've got a dictionary there.
Yes.
Could you go to page 330?
Okay.
And could you go down 7 word entries?
7 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What's the word?
Loony.
No! It's loony!
Now, Simon, you were thinking of a word, you wrote it down. What was your word?
Eat.
Eat. Howie, you picked a letter.
Yes, I did.
Hold your letter up and shout it out.
It's an E.
An E. E. What do you have there, Heidi?
I have an A.
And what do you have, Sophia?
A T.
Unbelievable! Thank you so much!
Quite a surprise.
Oh,
you're so funny, and I didn't expect to have so much fun. Howie,
you're a very good magician. You're funny. I love you. I'm a huge fan of yours. You are the epitome of somebody that deserves to have their own show. I would go see you in Las Vegas.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Heidi!
I think that you are adorable, and can I keep this?
Yes, of course.
Simon.
We saw everything, didn't we? I mean, you were mind reading, you were funny, you're very naughty. I really like you.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
So we're gonna vote. Heidi.
It's a yes from me for Mandy.
Oh, thank you so
Simon.
Much.
Simon.
It's a yes.
Howie.
3 yeses.
Oh.
Really good.
I'm absolutely in shock. That was amazing. I couldn't believe how he said it. It was like, he's such a hero of mine. I was like, oh my God.
She is great.
Thank you so much. Celebrate.
Thank you.
Introducing the nimble and agile, Mandy Newden.
That's amazing. These are my original hips. Hello, everyone. It's lovely to be back. But actually, I'm here for a very special reason. Apparently, there's a very famous, handsome, gorgeous celebrity who wants to go on a date with me. They've only told me the initials, S.C. Simon, any idea who that could be?
Gorgeous, handsome, it could be me.
I think it could. Oh, look, Terry Crews is here to assist me. The most expensive assistant in history. Hello. Oh, look at you. I've come over all unnecessary. Oh, Terry, look, you look beautiful. Now, reach in. I'm nervous about this date with a handsome, gorgeous celebrity. So I've written down every single item of clothing I own, and I've popped it in a bag, and I just want you to reach in and make sure that they're all different, just in case.
Okay,
what do you got there, Terry?
I got a few here. This one says red skirt.
Red skirt, and lovely.
This one says blue blouse.
Blue blouse, that sounds good, doesn't it? Blue blouse. What else you got, Terry?
Let's see, just read one more, otherwise we'll be here for weeks. It is...
You took more than you could handle.
Yellow jacket.
Yellow jacket. That is amazing, Terry. Would you take that down to the judges?
Oh, okay.
You look at you, you look absolutely gorgeous. Judges, could you take one piece each? Don't take a different colour and don't open them. Different colour from any other judge and don't open them. I'm going to get ready for my date. There we are, Simon. What colour have you got?
I've got green, Mandy.
You've got green. Lovely. What colour have you got, Sophia?
I've got yellow.
Lovely. And what colour have you got, Heidi?
I have red.
Red. And what colour have you got, Howie?
Blue for the Jew.
Lovely. Terry, could you take my handbag back to the dressing room? Do you like Jell-O?
I do, yeah.
Yeah, you're in for a big surprise. I'll see you in a minute. Now then... Simon, do you like a woman who can touch her own toes?
Yes. Yes.
Simon, do you like a woman who swings on a trapeze very, very low?
Yes, whoa. I do.
Simon, do you like a woman who's flexible?
Very much.
Simon, do you like a woman who will literally bend over backwards? This position in the Kama Sutra is known as some people will do anything to get on the telly. Simon, do you like a woman with a restraining order? Now, Howie.
Yes.
You chose a garment. You chose a piece of paper. What's written on it? What color is it? And what is the garment?
It's blue, and it says blue trousers.
Fabulous. Okay, Heidi, what color?
Red, and mine says red trousers.
Oh, does it?
It kind of...
Okay.
It does.
Sophia, what color do you have?
Yellow trousers.
Oh, no. Simon, what have you got?
Shall I tell you, Mandy?
Yes.
Green trousers.
Now, this is the wonderful thing about live entertainment, everybody. Sometimes it goes wrong. You've all chosen trousers. No magician on earth could make a lovely outfit out of trousers, except Magic Mandy. Simon, Do you like a voluptuous woman in a romper made out of four different pairs of trousers, half woman, half hot air balloon?
Very much.
Oh, Simon.
Yes.
I can't go on a date with you dressed like this. Brace yourselves! Magic Mand is ready!
Mandy Newton! Howie!
You know, you've given us so much. You really have. You give us comedy. You give us magic. You give us quick change. You make us laugh. You entertain. I think you checked every box. I think you got a good shot of getting into the finals. America, vote. Only two can come through. I love what you did.
Thank you.
Heidi.
I feel like the magic could use a little bit more wow. A little bit more wow, like your personality is wow. You know, you remind me kind of Patsy from Absolutely Fabulous, Darling Sweetie. You know, so yes. I feel like I love that persona that you have, or that personality that you have. I feel like we need a little bit more oomph on the magic.
Yeah.
Sophia?
Well, I can tell you worked really hard on your act this time. And I thought that, you know what? You took a risk and you did amazing. It wasn't too much. It was super entertaining. You had a lot of, I don't know what it was. And it was fun.
But there was a lot of it.
It was fun.
Well, Simon, you were laughing the whole time, man.
I mean, look, Mandy, you're very funny, really naughty. Look, I'm not saying the magic's the best I've ever seen, but look, I have seen Mandy on the British show before, and what I will say about Mandy is that Mandy, I'm talking for you, has done all of these terrible little gigs to get to where she's got to, so the fact that you're here in Hollywood tonight, bravo.
No!
Now, Mandy, now that you're all dressed with your date with Simon, what are your plans?
Oh, I don't know. It depends what Simon wants to do.
Naughty, I guess. What does it mean? How does it mean being here on AGT right now?
Do you know what? Just to be here, right now, is incredible. And I'm very, very grateful for this opportunity.
Hey, my name is Orlando. I'm happily married. 20 years. 20 years married, guys. 20 years. Yeah. She's my best friend. She's my best friend. Is she my best friend? Jason was my best friend. I haven't seen Jason in 20 years. No, I haven't. Should send him a text. She's my best friend, man. Well, actually, we dated for 5, and we've been married for 15, where she can get half. So, yeah, I was a lease with an option to buy, and she bought it. Hopefully, it'll be a good investment. Let's see how this turns out. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. 20 years, guys. 20 years in the same spot. 20 years. And don't get me wrong. I get invited to other spots all the time. Yeah, because I'm adorable. And, I always turn it down because I love my spot. I love my spot. I'm loyal. Yes, I'm loyal. I'm loyal. Yeah. And I'm not good at multitasking. No, I'm not. I'm not good at multitasking. That's a lot of hard work, taking out the trash at 2 different houses, you know? Yeah. Fixing the toilet at 2 different houses. Oh. Seeing the same movie twice, pretending I don't know the ending. Oh, I wasn't expecting that. Yes, I was. Wow, we just figured that out together. My laziness keeps me loyal. She's no longer allowed to complain. You're so lazy. Ha, you better thank God. Whenever you're looking for me, where am I? Right there. I'm either on the stage or on the couch. I'm not hard to find. Side note, if you're married and your husband's very active, going to the gym and stuff, keep an eye on him. Kind of suspect. I wouldn't trust him. Yeah, I don't trust married dudes that work out and have a six-pack. Why? Why do you have a six-pack? Why? Who are you, Terry Crews? No. No, you're not. He's on TV and you work in IT. No. That's not the way it works. That's not natural. The way it works is that you say, I do, and poop, you get a little belly. Yeah, this belly isn't even for me. This belly's for her. She has a bad day at work. Now she can come and rest her head on my belly. What? They didn't invite you to lunch. Forget those ladies. Get over here. Team us. Team us. Yes. 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 You're my best friend. You're my best friend. My name's Orlando Leyva. It's an honor and a pleasure, everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Woo. Orlando Leyva! Oh, I got hit by the bus, man. Howie!
You know, Orlando, you're a smart man. You really are, because I told you before, I love you. You're a natural. I think your life has changed because of this show, and the world gets to see you. But more than that, I love your plan. You know, on last week, the comedian, I think, screwed up because they told one story and no jokes. And before in the package, you said, I'm just going to keep throwing them out there. Yeah. You threw out a million pitches, and every one of them was a home run.
Thank you. Simon, do you agree?
I do, because I think, I said this before, Sherry, I think, you know, the comedians have the hardest time. I really, really do.
Yes.
Because you have to feed off the audience. And if they're not laughing, it's a nightmare. And they were laughing. But you are naturally funny. And your material was great. I think people are going to really like you. And I like you. Yeah. And thank you so much for being on our show this year.
Heidi, you like this?
I do. I like you. And I can totally see you filling a lot of seats in Las Vegas. Everyone was laughing here.
I hope you show up.
I will show up. I thought you were very funny, and you are very adorable.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sophia.
I mean, Orlando, you're likable, relatable, you're adorable, everything.
You love relationship comedy, don't you?
Hey, ignóralo. You need to go through your process. You need to
Orlando, I gotta ask this, man.
I mean, America must vote for you because you're great.
Yes.
Thank you.
But I gotta ask a question. What did your wife think about how you delivered tonight? Is she here in the audience?
Oh, she's here. She's loved this whole process. I'm getting a lot of loving at the house. I'm getting.
For the odd person that is watching at home or doesn't know, you are a superstar from this last season, season 17, on AGT. You blew up. You're a comic superstar. I know you've been traveling. I know I offered you a job with me opening up. You haven't had time. That's how busy. People are recognizing you on the street. With all that going on, why come back for more?
Here's the thing. I didn't win. That's why I was here.
There you go.
I wanted the title. I wanted to be the first comedian ever. And then when I left, I was devastated.
Good for you.
So when I got the call, I never stopped working, and I just kept tightening, writing, fixing everything.
Yes.
You know? You want a show?
Yes, we do. Yeah.
No more questions. Give us the show.
Okay.
I love him for saying that.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. Okay. So, AGT has been changing my life, but it's been changing my family's life even more, especially my stepson. For those of you that don't know, my wife's older. I got a stepson. We like the same age. I call him Stepman. All right? And he's been exhibiting unusual behavior because he's upset that I portrayed him on the show as irresponsible and gets in trouble in school. So he's been trying to prove he's responsible by buying products around the house with my money. And I didn't even know. I walked in on him eating his cereal. I'm like, hey, don't waste that milk. He's like, I bought it. And he doesn't waste the milk. He walks the bowl of milk past the sink and places the bowl of milk inside of the refrigerator. So first, I'm like, who reuses cereal milk? But then I was like, how good would my cereal taste double cocoa puffed up?
True.
All these years I've been single milking it. I just needed my milk to marinate. The fame is affecting Stepman. He's been invited to all these parties, but he's been staying out too late. So my wife and I, we've been deciding how to handle it. I'm like, I don't know what to do. She's like, go get him. I drove around the corner to pick him up. I came home 3 hours later. She said, Michael, you've been drinking? I'm like, we got some of the same friends. Everybody was there. He's still there. I'm gonna go get him again. I'll find out why you weren't invited. And on top of all of that, I have responsibilities in the community. I'm a Little League coach, yes. Yeah.
Yeah, we have a 12-year-old together. Yeah, that's the one we call Real Kid. And they call me Coach Fro because I can't fit the hat. I just set it on top. I love coaching. You know, I just hate when kids get hit by the pitch because it is not supposed to be funny. But baseball is a game of technique. When the ball's coming at you, you turn and you brace. But a lot of the kids, they get afraid and they get hit in the worst places, like the center of the back. And I see it happening. The ball's coming and they turn and like, And the worst thing you can do when you're holding in your laugh is look at another person. You know, And the kid's like, I can hear you. The pitch was 25 miles per hour. She's trying to kill me. Hey, you guys, I'm Mikey Winfield. Thank you very much, America. Thank you, America. Thank you very much. Wow. All right. All right, let me start by saying this. I love my wife. I love my family. I got a super old stepson. You know, It's weird because my buddies, close friends, they won't date women with kids, which is strange to me because it changed my life. I never thought like I had such a deep love for this child support check. Every other Thursday, me and Stepman wait outside by the mailbox. I got this new move I do for the mail lady when she shows up. I'm like, thank you. Because that's how Stepman and I bond. We buy stuff with the child support check. It's not a lot of money, but we get to hang out, you know? My close friends, they don't even know. They just know the stuff. They're like, dude, where'd you get that jacket? I'm like, my baby daddy. You need to get you one, playboy. I'm just trying to find my parenting flow, you know? Because my parents, they had unique approaches. I remember when I started stand-up, my mom, she just quit her job, zero savings. She said, Jesus is gonna pay her bills. And several years later, she had zero debt. She made me a believer. Because that's when I found out that I was Jesus. Trying to find my parenting flow. So me and Stepman, we hang out. We went to an appliance store. We're leaving, we're in a parking lot. Some lady, she runs out to me. She's like, sir, you forgot this. I'm like, thank you, ma'am. It wasn't mine. I just got nervous. I thought she was coming to tell me my transaction didn't go through. But instead, I got hooked up with some Hoover vacuum cleaner bags, right? But then I'm like, what am I doing? I don't steal. I'm supposed to be a role model for Stepman here. Let me handle this. I'ma handle this. Stepman's like, I'll handle it. I'm like, okay. And he handled it. Stepman handled it. He went back inside of the store and stole a vacuum cleaner. And there's my parenting flow. I'm Mikey Winfield. Good night. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Mikey Winfield.
Take it. Looking so good. Simon, your golden buzzer.
Mike, you were so funny when we saw you earlier on, and there was only one thing you had to do tonight, be funnier, and you were. I mean, brilliant.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
I think you've given yourself a shot after that. And I know we say this a lot, and all these shows say this, oh yeah, you're a star. You are a star.
Thank you, Simon.
Howie!
Oh, I agree with everything you're saying. And wouldn't that be great? We've never had a comedian win even AGT, let alone AGT All-Stars. I hope it. I wish it. We now know him and we love him and we're waiting for the next story about Stepman, which should end up being a show with Terry Crews.
Yeah, I'll be Stepman.
Being your Stepman. That's a great series right there. It's amazing.
Heidi!
Yeah. I mean, you are just a true entertainer in the best possible way. I mean, you just have it all. You have the full package, and that smile does win me over every time. And so do your jokes, by the way.
Thank you, Heidi. Thank you. I appreciate it. Now, Mike, You always said you wanted to be the first comedian to win AGT. How's that working for you right now?
You know what? Here's the thing. I was devastated when I left and I lost, you know? And then when I got the call, I felt like I had a second chance. And I feel like now is that second chance. And I'm riding the wave of Simon's golden buzzer, and I just feel like I have a shot. Right now, I have a chance.
I believe you, Mike.
Thank you. Good luck tonight, Mike.
We live. What's up?
I'm so glad to be here, man, with you all, man. What's up, America? What's up, everybody? Yeah, I got my family in the house. My wife is here. My kid is here. It's so great being married, man. People don't talk about the positives of marriage. Marriage go good sometimes. You always hear people like, it's always, no, it goes good. I remember one day me and my wife, it's a true story, we was having a great day. You ever having a great day with your mate? Everything's going well. You know what I mean? You looking at them, they looking at you like, I'm so glad I fixed you. And you looking back like, I'm glad I fixed you too. You're so silly. We was having one of those days, she's acting silly. She's like, let me ask you a question. I was like, okay. She's like, let me ask you a question. Listen, okay. I'm like, if we playing, it's like, you could be any animal you want, okay? If you could be any animal you want, what animal would you be? I was like, and she's like, wait, I'd be a lioness. I was like, okay, that's sexy. Okay, lioness. She's like, what animal would you be? You could be any animal you want. So I'm thinking, you know, because I really wanted to take, when you say, what animal would I be, I want to make sure the animal represent me. So I started thinking of different animals. I haven't watched the Animal Channel in a while. So I was thinking about the bear. He aggressive, but I don't want no gut. So I was like, yeah, no, not the bear. I was thinking of the deer. You know, I see the deer on the picture. I was like, no, that don't really, that ain't really me. And I thought of an eagle. An eagle, it's something regal about an eagle. I said, I would be an eagle, babe. She said, you'll be a what? I said, I'd be an eagle. She said, what did I say I'd be? You said you would be a lioness. She said, and what you say? I said, I would be an eagle. And you don't see nothing wrong with that. Baby, you said whatever I want to be. So do that mean you want to fly away from this relationship? Is that what you're saying? Huh? Babe, what you talking about? Are you saying you don't want to be with me? Is that what you're saying? I'm like, babe, what are you talking about? She's like, how are we going to be together? I'm like, babe, calm down. We were just having a great time. What happened? Hold on. You said whatever I want to be. I didn't know we was together in this animal kingdom. I didn't know that. I didn't know that's what it was. She's like, how you not know that? I'm like, I didn't know. She's like, we together. I was like, I didn't know in the animal world, but okay, my bad. I'm trying to reel it back in. I'm like, my bad. I'm a lion. She's like, no, don't be a lion because I don't want to change you. You always talking about trying to change you. So never mind. Let me ask you this, Mr. Eagle. Would you at least come visit me? And I'm thinking, do eagles visit lions? I don't think so. I'm like, babe, I don't think so. She's like, so you wouldn't even come check on me? I'm like, babe, I would be an eagle. I don't think eagles and lions hang out. She was like, Simba had friends all over the jungle. What do you mean? I said, babe, that's a movie. She's like, this real life. And so we in counseling because I wanted to be an eagle. I just wanted to be an eagle. Thank you, America!
Barry Brewer Jr. Howie!
You know, Barry, you have the most important ingredient a comedian needs, and that is likability.
Thank you.
I think that you, no matter what you set up there, the audience is going to love you and be drawn to you. I think you took a shot. You know, this was one story, you know, whereas if you had jokes and you were throwing jokes, you could, it was one. If they weren't going to go with you, but they went with you. And they went with you because you're likable and you're a good storyteller.
Thank you so much.
Simon!
Barry, look, I totally agree with Howie. I think, you know, you're really, really likable. You're very funny. However, I'm going to be honest with you. Your okay. first audition, it was so different behind the keyboards, and I was really hoping that you would do the same thing for the live shows. I think if you had have done, you would have given yourself a much, much better shot. Because because we've seen, I don't know, I'd never seen an act like that before, a comedian singing at the same time. And so I'm struggling because of what I just said. I like you. I preferred your first audition.
Heidi, do you agree?
That's okay.
No, don't boo him. Thank you.
I like the story, and you had me. Like, I was laughing out loud, but I do agree with Simon. I did like the accompanying of the keyboard because it made you stand out from the other comedians.
Gotcha.
But you're still very, very talented, and I think America should still vote for you, because you are amazing and funny.
Primero, yo soy un elefante. ¿No? Okay. Quizás un perrito. Ruff, ruff.
No. Is that supposed to be a dog?
Okay. Entonces, yo soy el Jason Statham.
I got one last job for ya. And this time, it ain't gonna be easy.
That's perfect.
Okay, ustedes les quitan personas famosas, entonces aquí hay otra. Este es el David Attenborough.
The Chilean clown is known for surviving solely off laughter. Therefore, this clown is in mortal danger.
Está bien. Okay, otra para ustedes. Este es el Jimmy Fallon. Great show night, everybody. We got Adam Driver in the house. Now, Adam Driver, I've been meaning to ask you, man, like, what's going on?
What's going on, Jimmy, is that I'm an incredibly gifted actor. And if you do not agree with that, then you do not know what I am capable of!
Whoa! Adam Driver, ¿no es cierto? Okay. Tengo una más para ustedes. Esta es la última, last one. Este es el Simon Cowell.
I don't mean to be rude, but I've seen funnier clowns in horror films.
Yes!
Amazing. I'm surprised. I thought you were gonna come and, you know, clown around. I'm gonna be honest, this was very big surprise. Good for you.
We look for moments and we look for surprises. And you are a moment and you are a surprise. The way you started out with the animal noises, we thought, oh, this is a joke act. And then you are one of the best impressionists I've ever heard.
I thought your impressions were amazing. What I even loved most is how excited you were when it worked out in the end. You did your impression and then you were so happy with yourself when you were laughing, that made me laugh.
seriously. I don't know what to say. I've never seen or met a funny clown in the world. You might be the only one.
Muchas gracias.
Bueno, vamos a votar. We're going to vote for you.
Okay.
I'm going to give you the first yes.
Simon.
Two yeses.
Heidi.
Second.
Four yeses.
Want to hate people, you don't want to hate people, they make us hate them, we're victims. So right now, I like all of you. Don't screw it up. You know what I don't like? I don't like when people profile me as a middle-aged woman. My own sister for my birthday gave me a bread maker. Yeah, because look at me, clearly I want to bake bread. Like, what am I, a pilgrim? What is happening in America? There has been a resurgence of women who are knitting and quilting. Stitch and bitch societies are popping up all around the country. my sister says to me, Maureen, why won't you try crocheting? Why? Because we had an industrial revolution. Yes. It's the reason I'm not down at the banks of the river beating my bloomers on a rock. I gotta tell you, no, I don't like being profiled. I got a call from an agent. He said, Maureen, I want you to perform on this big event, but you have to do menopause jokes. I'm like, you know, I can't, you know, not my thing. I don't have symptoms. He says, well, it pays $17,000. I said, oh my God, I just had a hot flash. Like, I can't stop sweating. I can't stop sweating. Can't stop sweating. So now I gotta head to the Bloomingdale's to get the makeup and the young, hopeful, dewy thing, like one of you, goes, they make product for your irritated skin. I'm like, well, that's not what's irritating me right now. Yeah, but your skin, it's mature, as if it's contagious, which it is. She'll get it in 20 years. You have to go over there to the mature skin counter, way, way, way over there, past your prime. Keep going, keep going. You'll see rage, regret. Go, go, go to the belly fat, the broken marriage, the gay ex-husband. Well, he was a golfer. It's the same thing. It is, it is, it is. Go, keep going, stay focused. Get to the gingivitis, the diverticulitis, the deep vein thrombosis. That's not a musical instrument. When you get to the adult dignity diapers, stop, you're in the right place. Dignity diapers? And my doctor goes, well, you know, Maureen, at your age, you may need them because you could get sudden bladder leakage. Oh. I'm like, oh, that's awesome. When's that gonna happen? And she said, suddenly. I mean, it could be tonight. I have no idea. I wouldn't wear open-toed shoes. I mean, that's why I wear boots. That's why I wear boots. But you guys, I don't want to deal with any of this. I don't want to deal with any. I want to run away from all of it. But I can't run because I have a little rip in my hip. I do. I'm seeing a physical therapist. He's digging into my hip flexor. Dig, 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 dig. Tears are in my face. He sees I'm in pain. He says, Maureen, in your mind, go to your special place. I said, well, you're so close. Why don't you go there? I'm Maureen Lankin, you guys. I could never hate you.
Maureen Lankin. Sophia.
You can tell that you have been practicing and going out there. I mean, you feel so confident. You feel like you're having fun. I can relate to all your jokes. I love you.
If I could look like you, it would help me get through them.
Simon.
I like you, and I think people are going to like you, and I respect you, by the way. I think it's the hardest thing, you know, when you're following singers, dancers, you know, and it's loud, and you're only out there on your own. You're relying on your jokes. What I didn't hear was that big, big moment when something, one joke landed. I think it was good. I didn't love the audition.
Howie, you know comedy. What's up?
I do. You know, you said you wanted to show that you're professional, consistent. You showed us you're professional, you're consistent. I also think that this is a big family show. And I've been married for a long time. I think you did land big jokes for women out there that kind of understand and relate with you. And your closing joke for me was the big, was your special place, which is also my special place, too.
Maureen, what does your family think about you being here at the AGT semifinal?
Well, my dad is a retired New York City sanitation worker, so he's really proud. And my mom is from Ireland, so she's always said, don't make a show of yourself. Don't bring attention to the family. The neighbors will know. So I think in this instance, she's happy I made a show of myself.
All right.
One more time.
do stand-up comedy.
Simon's face is like this.
Look at Simon's face.
In Norway, that means you're doing really good. Oh.
Is there any more? Is there any more?
Come on, please.
Honestly?
Okay, any more?
You want more?
No. No.
I love this song so much!
Simon? I'll be serious today. I'll do as Simon says. I'll put this hair and I introduce myself properly. My name is Viggo Venn. That means my mother is Norwegian and my dad is a diagram. I did stand up!
Yes!
I feel like we should get to know each other a bit closer.
Please. Yes!
Yeah? My name is Viggo.
My name is My name is
Viggo. Yeah. You want to try to?
No.
Okay.
Yes. My name is
My name is Viggo. You are Bruno, the new guy.
Yes.
Oh, I forgot.
The new guy.
Thank you for reminding me. Okay, I have to do all the work here. Are you ready?
Yes.
I am ready again.
I start there, I come back to you.
Yes. Are you coming back? I promise.
My name is... My name is... My name is... Alicia. My name is... My name is...
Wow, so much attitude.
My name is... My name is... My name is... Alicia. My name is... My name is...
Whoa. That's so good. Okay, Brenda.
My name is my name is
my name is Blue. Oh, my name is Blue.
Oh, my name is my name is.
Someone was drinking before the show.
Oh, my name is Blue. Oh, my name is my name is
my name is Blue.
Oh, my name is Blue.
Oh,
my name is my name is
my name is Blue. Oh, my name is.
You want to try too? Okay.
My name is. My name is. My name is.
Hello, darling. It's Amanda.
My name is. My name is.
A little bit sexy.
My name is. My name is. My name is.
Hello, darling. It's Amanda.
My name is. My name is. My name is.
Hello, darling. It's Amanda.
Enthusiastic judge in the world.
My name is my name is
Cow.
My name is my name is
Cow.
My name is
I could do this all night.
My name is my name is
Cow.
Can I
just keep? Can I do it to just
yeah.
Can I do it just one?
No. No, no, no.
Darling, it's Amanda.
Hello, Apollo! Wow! Can I tell you a Norwegian joke? Yeah? This is a really good one. You're gonna love it. There were two karer som gikk inn på Njø scene og så... Have you heard it before? I think it's time for me to show my real talent, don't you think? Yeah! Alicia, you know, I struggle a bit with the language, but tonight I've written a song.
Okay. Ooh. Great.
Ooh.
What do we do now?
Well, we're live, so we just gotta...
What should I do now?
Do you have another one?
For you.
What?
Oh, you know
what it is. But thank you so much for having me on your show, and I have a little gift.
What's that? Is that for me? Can I open it now?
Yeah.
Did you buy it for me?
I picked it myself.
One more time.
Okay.
Vigo, you're staying. You're in the final three. Don't go anywhere. We're left with Liliana Clifton, Vigo Venn, and Killian O'Connor. The public chose you as this year's final three, but only one of you will leave here as this year's winner. The third place act in Britain's Got Talent 2023 is... Third place is Killian O'Connor! Wow! Third! Amazing!
Absolutely amazing.
Amazing! Thousands of people and you've made it to third.
Yeah.
What do you want to say to everybody who voted for you?
Thank you, everyone. It's been an incredible journey. Thank you.
You've been amazing, Killian. Wow. Let's hear it one more time for third place. Incredible year of auditions, five unbelievable semi-finals and an amazing final. It all comes down to this.
Just two acts remain, Liliana Clifton and Vigo Venn. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2023 is...
Listen, you were brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Let's hear it one more time for this year's runner-up, Liliana Clifton!
Thank you, darling.
Well, would you look at that? Congratulations, Vigo Venn, you are the winner of Britain's Got Talent 2023.
I feel extremely visible right now. Thank you so much.
The heart of Britain. Loads of people have voted for you. What would you like to say to the people who voted for you?
Not just the heart of Britain, but the heart of Simon.
Yeah, you did.
But thank you so much, everyone who voted for me. That's you want more?
Year's winner. We would like to say thank you to our fantastic judges, Bruno Tognoli, Alicia Dixon, Amanda Holden, and Simon Cowell.
Can we just say a huge thank you to every single act that turned up and auditioned? Come on, judges, come and join us. We could not do the show without the acts. Thank you.
Of course, the biggest thanks goes to you at home for watching. We'll see you all again soon. But for now, your winner, Vigo Venn!
Vigo!
Hello.
How are you?
My name is Bennett Kavanagh.
Is whatever you're going to do how you make a living?
No, so I make a living as a music teacher at the minute. Hopefully, hopefully this will take over and I can earn a career from that.
Fantastic. Good luck.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So, not only am I a comedian, I'm a musical comedian. Give me a cheer if you're a fan of the guitar. Yeah, well, that's a real shame. So, I'm able to get on with what I can do with a lot of grace and dignity. I really hope I achieve that today. Here's the first song. I got into an Uber, but it was not for me. And I was too awkward to get out, so now I live in Leeds. I should explain, Amanda. Uber, it's like a chauffeur you get from your phone. Just there.
I'm enjoying this now.
This next song is called An Episode of Medieval Top Gear. Hey, what's the horsepower on that thing? One.
Simon loves it.
I knew a girl who had a smoking habit, and that's why she was a terrible nun.
Oh my God, Simon finds this funny. Now we're in trouble.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Oh, Bennett. You've made somebody very happy.
Actually, it was funny.
Thank you.
Oh,
thank
really? You. I actually don't find comedians that funny, but you made me laugh.
Thank you very much.
Oh no, she's going to dance.
Oh, there's stuff on the screen.
Oh, what?
Stapler.
Oh, she's being a stapler.
She's a stapler.
Is that it? We can do that.
Hang on. Sharpener.
Rubber. Here we go. Sourdough?
She just looks like angry bread.
Baguette!
How have you even got this axe? How's that a brioche?
Washing machine!
It doesn't make any sense at all. Look, spaghetti? Macaroni?
You're gonna love me.
We're getting credit.
Oh my God, that's the mirror you said. I love it, thank you.
No.
It's my...
Oh, I just drank out of yours by accident.
Oh, no!
Oh, my God.
Why did he grab your cup?
I don't know. I would get so excited. Stuff happens.
This has got Howie Mandel all over it.
What are you doing? Move them off.
Well, you were drinking out of my cup. I figured you were fine with my feet.
30 seconds.